ladies and gentlemen. He's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the U.S.
And good morning, America. This is the Patriot Radio Show. I am your host, Tom O'Halloran, and I'm broadcasting today from the underground bunker deep in Arcantana, Brascarado. I'm here to educate, irritate, and agitate. And folks, I'll guarantee you 100% agitation by the time the show's over. Again, my name is Tom O'Halloran, otherwise known as the Mouth from the South. My primary blog, TomOHalloran.com. When you get there, please follow my editor, Veronica Coffin. She manages several websites on our network, and without her doing that, I couldn't do this. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. And personally, I'm at facebook.com/O'Halloran. And I'm on air 5 days a week. We've returned to the morning hour. Every morning, Monday through Thursday, 9 a.m. Texas time, for this, the Patriot Radio Show. On Fridays, I do Jihad on America, where I cover the Islamists in America. I'll tell you who they are, what they want, and why you should be very, very afraid. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show Islam is Not a Religion, or my show on Islamophobia, then please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com and listen to all three of these shows. They will give you insight and perspective on the Islamic topic that you've probably not heard elsewhere. It'll also give you a solid foundation upon which we build each and every Friday as we continue pulling back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And I do the news about Islam around the world because it's a glimpse into the future of what's in store for us here in the homeland if we continue to allow the cancer of Islam to spread. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as catch up on the archives of any shows that you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. This show is rebroadcast daily on ConservativeRadioNetwork.com and on Liberty Works Radio Network. You can find them at LWRN.net. You can also take the show with you on your Android or iPhone. Download the TuneIn app and do a search for the Patriot Radio Show. If you're a ham radio operator, I am Whiskey 2 TPO and can usually be found on Echolink node 7212 out of Stagecoach, Texas. With that, we're going to jump right into the show. We got a lot to talk about today. Today is the big Northeast primary. We've got Connecticut, Pennsylvania, Delaware, and two other of those pseudo states, you know, little tiny things. It's just about the size of a match head on a map. It's a big day. Donald Trump has a 42-ish across the board for the five states, 42% average. So good, solid double digits in all the states. It's going to be a very, very good day for Team Trump. We're going to start with our weekly police misconduct update. For those of you that are listening for the first time, this show is very, very pro-law enforcement, but it's pro-lawful law enforcement. Anytime you have hundreds of thousands of people in any class, whether they're radio announcers, accountants, lawyers, school teachers, hundreds of thousands of people of any class, any group at all, you're going to have a certain percentage of bad eggs. I do this segment each week to show not that the police are acting up, but to show that when they get caught, they are being investigated and prosecuted. Something that wasn't always the case. Or if it was, it didn't get much media attention. Even now, the media doesn't tell you this stuff's going on. All of the cases we're going to talk about here in the next few minutes are currently in the news in the last couple of days. Some of these are new cases just being discovered. Some of them are being adjudicated. Some of them are being dismissed. But all of these are currently news items. Update. Bastrop County, Texas, first reported in June of 14, a now former deputy was acquitted of murder in the shooting death of Yvette Smith in a bench trial. One previous jury trial ended in a mistrial. The deputy was responding to a domestic dispute and thought the unarmed Smith had something in her hand as he entered the home with his rifle drawn. Jasper, Alabama. A now former officer pled guilty to extortion. He took payments from a drug dealer and in exchange gave the drug dealer information about police activity. Essex County, New Jersey. Police was ordered to pay A detective was ordered to pay $1.4 million to a man he wrongfully arrested. Witnesses testified that they were coerced by the officer to identify the man as the guilty party. Well, the detective isn't going to pay $1.4 million. That doesn't make sense. I'm going to click on that and see if I can get it a little more detailed during the break. Sometimes I make that happen, sometimes I don't. Madison County, Tennessee. A deputy was arrested for DUI. Update. Mansfield, Ohio. First reported in February of last year. An officer was found guilty of multiple felonies, including stalking and sexual battery. He used law enforcement computers and databases to find information about his victims. He was sentenced to 12 and a half years in prison. Great. Good to hear. These predators in blue deserve long prison sentences. California Highway Patrol, a now former officer, was acquitted of felony domestic violence. The jury hung on a misdemeanor charge. Update, Baltimore, Maryland, first reported August of last year. An officer was acquitted of assaulting a handcuffed fugitive by choking him. Baltimore, Maryland, an officer was acquitted of assault and misconduct in office for punching a detainee. A lot of acquittings, a lot of not guilties this week. Washington, D.C., an officer was arrested for pulling his gun on another motorist during an off-duty road rage incident. Jefferson County, Kansas, an officer was arrested for domestic battery and placed on administrative leave during the investigation. Update, St. Louis, Missouri. First reported last December, a now former officer was sentenced to probation. He wrecked his police vehicle while he was drunk and high on cocaine and then fled the scene. Gerald Ford International Airport, Michigan. And now former officer has been charged with misusing the police computer network. Update, Huntsville, Alabama. A decorated now former officer was sentenced to 2 years in prison for trying to bribe a fellow officer to drop drug charges against a third person. Boynton Beach, Florida. See, you wouldn't see that years ago. You could try to bribe, as a cop, you could try to bribe another cop, and he might take the money, he might not, but he'd never report you. But now they're reporting it,